Hello everyone and welcome to a new video from the microbiologist. Today we'll be talking about microbial limit test. This test is very important because it's used to detect any contamination occurred from aerobic bacteria, yeast or mold. This test includes total aerobic microbial count, total combined yeast and mold count, and test of pathogenic bacteria. Total aerobic microbial count is majorly used to detect and investigate bacteria, while total combined yeast and mold count is used to detect yeast and fungi. Test of pathogenic bacteria is used to determine any microorganism that shouldn't be found in pharmaceutical or food industries, such as E. coli, Salmonella, Enterobacteriaceae, Staphylococcus aureus, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Candida albicans, or any type of microorganism that can cause disease to us. Total aerobic microbial count and total combined yeast and mold count can be performed by Bohr plate method or membrane filtration method. Let me talk about Bohr plate method. Weigh 10 grams of solid materia or withdraw 10 milli of liquid materia, then transfer it into 90 milli of sterile sodium chloride peptone buffer and mix them so well. In case of detecting total aerobic microbial count, which majorly used for bacteria, add 1 milli of diluted buffer into sterile petri dish, then add sterile tryptone soybean agar media and incubate plates at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius for 3 to 5 days. While in case of detecting total combined yeast and mold count, add 1 milli of diluted buffer into sterile petri dish, then add sterile saccharide dextrose agar and incubate plates inverted at 20 to 25 degrees Celsius for 5 to 7 days. Kindly be notified that all handling should be examined under aseptic conditions. Sample must be mixed well in peptone buffer before pouring media. Agar to be poured must be 45 degrees Celsius or below. Negative control should be done in all samples to ensure the absence of microorganisms either in sterile buffer or agar media. The second method is membrane filtration method. This test is used for liquid material such as oral syrup, nasal solution, or any material that can be easily filtrated. Membrane filtration method depends on retaining microorganism on membrane filter and allowing it to grow on tryptone soybean agar or saccharide dextrose agar. Peptone buffer will pass throughout the filter while bacteria will retain on filter paper that can be easily observed after incubation. In case of detecting total aerobic microbial count, place the filter into tryptone soybean agar plate and incubate plates at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius from 3 to 5 days. While in case of detecting total combined yeast and mold count, place the filter into saccharide dextrose agar plate and incubate plate inverted at 20 to 25 degrees Celsius for 5 to 7 days. Test of pathogenic microorganisms. In order to detect any microorganism in a sample, we have to enrich it and let it increase in number that we can easily detect it in its own selective media. The best enrichment broth for many microorganisms is tryptone broth. Take 10 milli of diluted sample in the buffer and inoculate it into 90 milli of tryptone soybean broth. Then incubate tryptone broth at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius for 1 day. We can call this step by preparation of pathogenic test because we have to increase and enrich the microorganism in a sample before transferring it into its own selective media. Now I'm gonna talk about E. coli detection. After incubation tryptone broth for 1 day, shake the broth so well and transfer 1 milli of tryptone broth into 100 milli of McConkie broth and incubate it at 42 degrees Celsius for 1 to 2 days. After 2 days incubation of McConkie broth, streak on blades of McConkie agar and eosine methylene blue agar, which favor the growth of E. coli. On McConkie agar, growth of non-mycoid pink colonies indicates the presence of E. coli. And on EOC miscellane blue agar media, growth of green metallic sheen also indicates the presence of E. coli. Test of pathogenic salmonella. After incubation, Tripton broth shakes the broth so well and transfer 0.1 ml to 10 ml of Rabaport enrichment broth and incubate at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius for 1 day. After that, subculture on xylose lysine deoxycholate agar XLD and incubate at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius for 1 to 2 days. Growth of red colonies with black center indicates the presence of Salmonella species. In order to detect Staphylococcus aureus, streak directly from Tripton soybean broth after incubation 1 day to mannitol salt agar and incubate blades at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius for 1 to 3 days. Growth of yellow colonies surrounded by yellow zone indicates the presence of Staphylococcus aureus. We can confirm the presence of Staphylococcus aureus by performing catalase and coagulase test. Catalase test to ensure that the microorganism is gram-positive staphylococci species because staphylococci is catalase positive while streptococci is catalase negative. And among 26 species of staphylococci, Staphylococcus aureus is the only type that produce coagulase enzyme. Finally, we are going to talk about detection of Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Streak directly from incubated broth to citromide agar and incubate blades at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius for 1 to 3 days. Growth of fluorescent green color indicates the presence of Pseudomonas aeruginosa. To summarize everything said in this video, microbial limit test is used to detect microbial count and tell me if there is any contamination in the sample. TSA is used to detect total aerobic bacteria as it contains much simple neutrons that can be easily utilized by bacteria. Saccharose dextrose agar is used to detect total combined yeast and mold count as it contains complex neutrons that can be only utilized by the enzymatic action of yeast and mold. Optimum temperature for bacteria is 30 to 35 degrees Celsius, while optimum temperature of fungi is 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. To detect any pathogenic microorganism, you have to inoculate it into enrichment broth to encourage it to grow on its selective media. Thanks for watching. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel, and see you soon in next coming videos.